everybody. Hey. Ooh, this is the best crowd we've had already. This is awesome. I love that response. That's great. That's great. Wow. Oh my God. This is like, I'm sorry, this isn't stand-up comedy, but that was perfect for that kind of venue. That was really great. I want to thank you all so much for coming out tonight to Edgewater High School's production of Into the Woods. My name is Natalie Hawkins, and I am the theater director here. And I've been really, really fortunate to get to work with such a large group of talented students. From January till now, we've been working, rehearsing most weeks, 5 days a week for 3 to 4 hours a day. So these kids have been working so long and so hard for the show. And I'm really excited about it because it's paid off. I really think you'll realize that tonight. Something I wanted to kind of give a little shout out to some people that are here in the audience. Our principal, Dr. Shanoff, is here tonight. I know that one of our APs, Kenneth Bowles, is here tonight. And we also have a special teacher that's new at our school this year that has worked really, really hard to help us out with all the audio. And he's also doing the video recording with a bunch of students. He's training them to be professional video recorders. And his name's Mr. Graham, and he's in the back of the house. And then I also wanted to say a special thank you to Mr. Glover, who's out here leading the pit, and he's music director for the show. And someone that does not ever get enough credit are these amazing students that are our students that are in the orchestra pit. You may or may not know this, but a lot of schools, when they have an orchestra pit, they hire musicians, or they may have, you know, some adult professional musicians, like a mixture of professional musicians and then some students, to put together the pit. But our pit is entirely students, and they're amazing. So we're lucky. And we also have a huge group of technicians working on the show who you'll see them moving around scenery, but they've been planning, designing, creating, building a set for months, and I'm just super proud of them and our stage management. So please give a round of applause for them. And make sure when you look at your program tonight to notice all the student leaders that we have in our production crew. We have so many students that have really stepped up to lead this show, which makes my job a lot easier because they're doing a lot of the work and I'm just, you know, helping navigate them. But that's what we really want, are more student leaders. So it's really awesome. I want you to know tonight that after the show, when you're giving your applause, when we go like this, we are telling you to please applaud the pit for all their hard work. So when we do that, if you think the pit did a great job, which you're gonna think that, please make sure to really give them that applause. And when we go like this, we are giving you the signal to applaud for all the technicians in the show, the lights, the sound, the costumes, all of that. So please make sure to give them their due applause as well. I want to give you a few other things that we need to discuss. If in case there was an emergency and we needed to evacuate, there is an exit right here, up a couple steps and directly out of the building. And then also, as you came in those doors, those are our egress exit doors to go straight out of the building in case of emergency. Also, we are using strobe lighting in our show. So wanted you to know that if that's something that, you know, you need to know ahead of time, we will be using strobe lighting. And also we have a fog machine in our show. So please silence all your cell phones and enjoy the show. Thank you.
Once upon a time,
I wish
in a far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
lived a young maiden,
more than life,
sad young lad,
more than two,
I wish,
childless baker,
more than life,
wish, with his wife,
more than anything, more than the moon,
I wish
the king is giving a festival,
more than life.
I wish to go to the festive more than riches.
I wish my cow would give us some milk
more than anything.
I wish we had a child.
Please, Plow, squeeze, Plow.
I wish
you'd give us some milk for me and cheese.
I wish.
You wish to go to the festival.
The poor girl's mother had died.
The festival, the king's festival.
And her father had taken for his new wife.
The festival.
A woman with two daughters of her own.
Look at your nails, look at your dress.
People will laugh at me.
Nevertheless, I still wish to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
All through her beautiful face, but vile and black of heart. As for the lad, Jack, well, he had no father. And his mother?
I wish.
She was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. You foolish child, what in heaven's name are you doing with that toy inside the house?
A warm environment might be just what Milky White needs to produce his milk.
It's a toy, and how many times must I tell you? Only cheese can give milk. Why, come in, little girl.
I wish. It's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. A loaf of bread, please, to bring my poor old hungry granny in the woods. Just a loaf of bread, please.
Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied the pots of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them out again in 2 hours' time, then you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bun or four.
Are you really wearing that? Here,
I found a little tear, Cinderella. Can't you hide it with a hat? You look beautiful.
I know.
She means me.
Put it in a twist.
Who will be there?
Mother said be good. Father said be nice. That was always their advice. So be nice, Cinderella. Good, Cinderella. Nice, good, good, nice. What's the good of being good if everyone is blind and you're always left behind? Never mind, Cinderella. Kind, Cinderella. Nice, good, nice. Kind, good, nice.
Because the baker lost his mother and father in a baking accident, well, at least that is what he had believed, he was eager to have a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door!
Oh, we have no bread!
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell in their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother, she was with child. And she developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, grains, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fennel, ferns, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite.
The witch refused to tell him any more of his sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, but how was I supposed to know what your father had hidden in his back pocket? You see, when I inherited that garden, my mother warned me that I'd be punished with the curse of ugliness if I were to lose any of the beans! The special beans! I let him go, I didn't know he had stolen my beans! I was watching him crawl back over the wall, and then bang! Gosh! A lightning flash! Well, that's another story, never mind. Anyway, unless the big day came, I made my claim, don't you take away the baby, they shrieked and screeched, but I did, and I hid her, was it never be reached? And your father cried, and your mother died, and for extra measure, I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mollified. That your family tree would always be a bare one. Ah, that is just too funny. So there's no more fuss and there's no more scenes, and my garden thrives. You should sing right at the rings. But I'm telling you the same. I tell kings and queens, don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens, especially the beans.
Now, Jack, Milky White must be taken in the marketplace, and you are to bet no less than $5.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Now, how much are you to ask?
No more than $5.
Less than five. Jack, 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 head in a sack. The house is getting colder. This is not a time for dreaming. My old back is starting to crack. The mice are getting bolder. The tent's gone slack. Your mother's getting older. Your father's not back. And you can't just sit here dreaming pretty dreams. To wish and wish from day to day will never keep the wolves away. So into the woods, the time is now. We have to live. I don't care how. Into the woods to sell the cow. You must begin the
Piggy?
Meanwhile, the witch, for purposes of her own, explained how the baker might lift a spell.
You wish to have the curse reversed? I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back. One, the cow as white as milk. Two, the cape as red as blood. Three, the hair as yellow as corn. Four, the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight. In 3 days' time, and you shall have a guarantee. A child as perfect as dark can be. Go to the wood!
Ladies, our carriage awaits.
Now may I go to the festival?
The festival? Darling, those nails, darling, those clothes. Windows are one thing, but darling, but those. You make us the fool at the festival and mortify the prince. We must be gone.
Good night, Father. I wish.
Look what I found in Father's hunting jacket.
Six beans?
I wonder if they are.
The witch's beans! We'll take them with us!
No, you are not coming.
I know you are fearful of the woods at night.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No,
the spell
no,
is
the
on my house.
The spell is on our house. We must lift the spell together. The spell is on
no,
our house.
No, you are not coming, and that is final. And now what am I to return with?
You don't remember. The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
And so the baker reluctantly set out to meet the enchantress's demands. As for Cinderella,
if I ever to get to the festival, I know I'll visit Mother's grave and grieve at the hazel tree.
The slipper is pure as gold, the cow is white as milk.
I have to take the journey into the woods. The path is straight. I know it well, but who can tell? Into the woods to lift the spell. Into the woods to visit Mother. Into the woods to lift the spell.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival.
Into the woods without regret. The choice is made. The task is set.
Into the woods, but not forgetting why I'm on the journey. Into the woods to get my wish. I don't care how the time is now.
Make the potion.
To go to the festival. Into the woods to grandmother's house. Into the woods to grandmother's house. The way is clear. The light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees. The trees are just wood. No need to be afraid.
There's something in the glade there.
To lose the way into the woods, who knows what may be lurking on the journey. Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journey. Into the woods to see the king, to sell the cow,
to make the potion,
to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to lift, to go to the festival. Into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods, and home before dark.
There so often wept so much that her tears had watered it until it became a handsome tree.
I've been good and I've been kind, Mother, doing only what I learned from you. Why then am I left behind, Mother? Is there something more that I should do? What is wrong with me, Mother? Something must be wrong. I wish.
What, child? Specify. Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor, and good fortune, like bad, can befall when least expected.
I wish.
Do you know what you wish? Are you certain what you wish is what you want? If you know what you want, then make a wish. Ask the tree.
Quiver, little get my wish.
Not to my life.
Hello, Jack.
How'd you know my name?
When first I appear, I seem mysterious, but when explained, I'm nothing serious.
Say that again?
On your way to the market? You might have been there a long time ago. Taking your time, Jack?
No, sir.
Is that the truth?
Well, you see, now I'm resting.
How much are you asking of the animal?
No less than
$5.
Jack, why such a sum? Your mother? A boy your age, you'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
Come on, Monk White. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mrs. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
What might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so Granny can have something good to make her strong.
Where might your grandmother live?
Just a quarter of a league further in the woods. Her house lies beneath three large oak trees.
Come to the little girl in the red cape.
The little girl and get the cape.
You frightened me.
No. Oh, that's the cape. Get it, get it, get it!
How am I supposed to get it?
Well, you go up to the little thing and you take it.
can't just take a cloak from a little girl. Why don't you?
If I could, I would, but I really... My Rapunzel, listen to her beautiful music. Get me what I need! Get me what I need!
This is ridiculous. How am I ever going to get that red cape? Nor find the golden cow and the yellow slipper. Was it the yellow cow and the golden slipper? Oh no.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as...
What are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
You've no business being alone in the woods. You've no idea what I've come upon here. You would be frightened for your life. Now go home.
I wish to help.
No. The spell is on my house.
Our
Only
house.
Only I can lift the spell. The spell
we
is on my house.
We must lift the spell together. The spell is on...
My house.
Oh. A cow as white as... Milk! Hello there, young man!
What might you be doing with a cow in the middle of the forest?
I was headed to market, but I seem to have lost my way.
What were you planning to do there?
What were you planning to do there?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than $5.
$5? Where am I to get $5?
And if you can't fetch that sum, what are you to do?
Here's the sum total.
Beans! We mustn't give away our beans! Well, if you feel we must.
Huh?
Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans. These beans carry magic!
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him!
Magic that defies description!
Key to exchange her for a sack of beans!
Six.
Five. We can't part with all of them. Besides, I'd say they're worth about $1 each at the very least.
Can I buy my cow back someday?
Well, possibly. Good luck there, young man. Cow and go home.
I was only trying to be helpful.
Magic beans? We've no reason to believe they're magic. Are we to dispel this curse through deceit?
Oh, we were doing him a favor. No one would have given him more for this toy. Besides, now they'll have some food to eat.
Five beans.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in-betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Why you do what you do? It's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her. She's crying.
If the thing you do is pure and intent, if it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only three more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beans.
Take the cow and go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued to search for the cape as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose its beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. When the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth.
If you shine, still untouched by the sun. Children need protection just the way they need affection. Where they wandered and they wandered and they run from your little world.
Save any of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets and half the loaf of bread.
Where did you get this lovely red cape? I admire it so.
My Granny made it for me.
Is that right? I would love a red cape such as that.
You look pretty foolish.
May I take a look at it?
No, I don't like to be without my cape.
I want it badly.
No, please give it back!
I just wanted to make sure you really love this cape. Now, go home to grandmother's and make sure no wolves come your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day!
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak. What's a cloak? It's a joke. It's a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it. So you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker went after that red cape. As for the little girl, she was surprised to see her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Grandmother? My grandmother, you're looking awfully strange. What large ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what large eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what large hands you have.
The better to hug you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what a big, wet, awful, scary mouth you have.
The better to eat you with.
Scarcely had the wolf said this than within a single bound she was devouring the little girl. It had been a full day of eating for both, and with her appetite appeased, the wolf took to bed for a nice, long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore. Odd. Where's the little one? Eating, no doubt. Or eaten. Grandmother? Ha! that red cloth in the corner of your mouth. It appears to be... Aha! I'll get the cloak from within your stomach!
What a fright! How dark and dank it was inside that wolf!
Thank you.
I'll kill the devil! Take that knife and cut his evil head off! I want to see this enemy 1,000 bits! Better yet, let's watch this animal die agonizing, horrible death. Granny!
Shh.
Child, this evil must be destroyed.
I'm gonna just leave you to your task.
Well, don't you want the skins?
Oh, no. You keep them.
What kind of hunter are you?
I'm a baker.
Ugh!
Mother said straight ahead, not to lay or be misled. I should have heeded her advice, but she seemed so nice. And she showed me things, many beautiful things, that I hadn't thought to explore. They were off my path, so I never had dared. I had been so careful, I never had cared. And she made me feel excited, well excited and scared. When she said, come in, with that sickening grin, how could I know what was in store? Once her teeth were bare, then I really got scared. Well, excited and scared. But she drew me close and she swallowed me down. Darn a dark, slimy path where lay secrets that I never want to know. And when everything familiar seemed to disappear forever at the end of the path, was Granny once again. In a cape and a hood, they will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care of strangers, even flowers have their dangers. And though scary is exciting, nice is different than good. Now I know, don't be scared, Granny is right, just be prepared. Isn't it nice to know a lot? And a little bit not. Mr. Baker, you saved her lives. Here.
Are you certain?
Yes, maybe my granny can make me a new one out of the skins of that wolf.
Thank you!
Ew!
Woohoo!
And so the baker, with the second article in hand, feeling braver and more satisfied than he had ever felt, ran back into the wood. As for the lad Jack...
Only an adult would exchange a cow for beans! No! To bed, and no supper for you!
Little did they know, those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Yes, I just need to catch my breath. Well, what a lovely gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Oh, aren't you the lucky one? Why ever are you in the woods at this hour?
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see over there.
I've never lied to a prince before. I've never anything to a prince before.
Thank you.
Oh, now if a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
Well, what are you doing here? And with a cow?
Oh, well, my husband's off in the woods. He's undoing a spell. Now the prince, what was he like?
Well, he's a very nice prince.
And?
And it's a very nice ball.
And?
When I entered, they trumpeted.
And the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes, and?
And it made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
He has charm for prince, I guess.
Yes.
I don't meet a wide range, and it's all very strange.
Well, are you to return to the festival tomorrow eve?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? Oh, to be pursued by a prince! All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Would you look at that? It's like an enormous vine growing next to that little cottage.
I mean, slippers.
It looks like an enormous beanstalk rising into the sky.
As pure as gold.
I must get home.
Wait, I need your shoe.
Wait. Red.
Back, it's mine.
One midnight's gone.
No knot unties itself.
Sometimes the things you must wish for are not to be touched.
The harder to get, the better to have.
Agreed?
Agreed.
Never wear mauve at a ball.
Or pink.
Open your mouth. The difference between a cow and a bean is a bean pecan and an adventure.
Slotted spoons don't hold much soup.
The prettier the flower, the farther from the path.
The closer the pack, the closer the wine.
One midnight gone!
Summer does not send dogs to a prince.
Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor.
You may know what you need, but to get what you want, better see that you keep what you have.
One minute
gone. Sometimes the things you must wish for.
The harder to get, the better to have.
One minute gone. Into the woods. And out of the woods and home before.
There were giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. Are the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you weigh a pint, you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known. When the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you. Exploring things you've never dared, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest. And she draws you close to her giant breast. And you know things now that you never knew before. Not to the sky. Only just when you made a friend and all, but you know she's big, but you know feels small, someone bigger than her, long the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's in that you miss all things you know, in the world you've left it a little, you own the fun is done. You steal what you can and run, and you scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The house and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
Good fortune, sir. Look what I have. 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She said I could do with these as I please.
Oh, my.
Where's Milky White?
She is at home with my wife.
Let's go find her.
No. I do not know if I wish to sell.
But you said I might buy my cow back someday.
Well, I do not know if 5 gold pieces...
Are you saying you wish for more money?
Well, more money is always
better. Stay here, I'll go fetch more.
No, wait. I didn't say I wanted... 5 gold pieces. With this, I could buy a new awning and baking supplies for a whole year.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem mysterious, but when I'm explained, I'm nothing serious. Could you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I've not thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. You have not thought about much, have you, son?
Wait a minute. Those are mine. Give them back.
The money is not what's important. What's important is that you wish be honored.
No. Damn you! Come back! Now what are you doing here?
Oh, I see you have the red cape.
Yes, I have the cape. Only 2 of the 4 items left to go.
3.
2, the cow and the cape.
You've the cape.
Where's the cow?
She was taken. I've been looking for her all night. I never reached home.
I knew I shouldn't have entrusted her to you.
She just might have easily have been taken from you.
But she wasn't.
But she might have.
But she wasn't.
But she might have.
The cows! The cow is gone. Now we're going to get it back, get it back, get it back!
We were just going to do that. Here, I can give you this.
No! Don't give me that, fool! Have you no sense? My Rapunzel again. Listen to her beautiful music.
Lovely.
She's very gifted.
By tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items to me, or your wish you never have thought to have a child. La-da-dee, la-da-da.
Oh. I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I'm sorry I yelled at you. Now please, go home. I will make things right, and then we can go about our lives. No more hunting about in the woods for strange objects. No more dim-witted boys and witches and hungry little girls. Go.
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you'd gone.
I'd been looking out all night for her.
Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared, like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
Oh, I'm not sure of that. I must confess that I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, it's on the top of a tall tower, has no door or stairs.
Where?
It's 2 miles from here, due east. It's just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
Well, I stand beneath her tower and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. Oh, and she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair. It's yellow as corn, so I climb to her.
Oh, Rapunzel, Rapunzel. What kind of name is that? You jest, brother. I've never heard such a ridiculous thing.
I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden. Maiden run from a prince? None would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Oh, agony, far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you, if there only were doors. Agony of the torture they teach. What's as intriguing
or half so fatiguing as
what's out of reach?
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate? passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne.
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why don't?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
No, you know nothing of madness. Till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her, ah, 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 ah. Agony, misery, woe, oh, it's different for each.
Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach.
Agony that can cut like a knife.
I must have her to wife.
Two princes, each one more handsome than the other. Oh, forget the princes. Find that hair.
Excuse me, young woman, have you encountered a boy with a sunny, yet occasionally vague disposition, answering by the name of Jack?
Not the one partial to the white cow.
He's the one!
Oh, have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again. Children can be so queer about their animals. You be careful with your children.
Well, I have no children.
That's okay, too.
Well, I have not seen your son today.
Oh, I hope he didn't go up that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I always say. Jack! Jack!
Moo! Moo! Moo!
Moo? Looking for your cow?
Where did you find her? Hello?
I'm here to make amends.
I told you to stay out of this, old man.
I'm here to see wishes granted.
You've caused enough trouble. Stay out of my path!
There are no witches to encounter. Oh! Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let your hair down to me.
Is that you, my prince?
Yes. Oh no. Excuse me for this. Oh! Take plenty of spills, don't you?
Yes, well, it's these shoes. They're not quite suited for these surroundings. They're not quite suited for dancing, either. So.
Oh, well, I'd say those slippers are pure as gold.
Well, they're everything you could wish for in beauty.
What I wouldn't give for just one!
Well, one wouldn't do you much good.
Now, was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
And
they have far too much food.
And the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh, who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
He must have really taken a liking to you.
Well, I have no experience with princes and balls and gowns.
Oh, nonsense! Every girl dreams.
Sir, look!
Yes,
there she is!
I must run!
I must have your shoe! Oh, just stop that!
I need it to have a child! And I need it to get out of here!
You! Where did she go?
Who?
Don't play the fool, woman!
Oh, you mean the beautiful maiden in the ball gown? She went in that direction. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can capture my own damsel, thank you.
Oh,
where did he go?
Who?
The prince, of course.
Yes.
direction, but you'll never reach him.
We would have if that mongrel with the cow hadn't have molested us!
Cow?
Please, let me just compare your hair to this ear of corn.
He wants to compare hair to corn!
You've the cow!
Yes, I've the cow. Only two of the four objects.
Three!
Two?
Three! Compare this to your corn!
Where did you find it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Three!
And I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
We've one entire day left. Surely we can find the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, I do suppose it will take the both of us to have this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the woods. If you could see.
One was enough, it's not true. It takes two of us, you came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It takes two of us, it takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you swear to change, who can tell if you do? It takes two.
You've changed. You're thriving. It's something about the woods. Not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. At home, I fear we'd stay the same forever.
And then once you be gone, it takes two of you, it's no fun. But what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us as a pair of us, each accepting a share of what's there.
We've changed. We're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who minds what dangers? I know we'll get past the woods. And once we're past, let's hope the change is less. Beyond woods, beyond witches and slippers and hoods. Just the two of us, beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us, it takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we had none, we've got three. We need one, it takes...
has fallen into my hands.
A golden egg? I've never seen a golden egg.
Oh, Providence, my Honky White, and the owner's in my egg. You see, I promised more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
So I'm taking my cow.
No, no, no. I never said I wished to sell.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
You took the 5 gold pieces?
I didn't take, you gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
Well, you see, an old man took them.
I want my cow.
I never said I wanted to sell. I said I may want to sell.
You would take money before a child?
Milky White is dead.
Two?
Midnight's gone.
Wanting a ball is not wanting a prince.
Fear may be
better than far, but it still isn't there.
It may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
The ball.
So near, so far.
You never let somebody else's trial.
The midnight's gone.
The way you love.
So near.
Your home.
The prince.
So far.
Two midnights gone. The exhausted baker and his wife bury the dead Milky White.
You will go to the village in search of another cow.
Do you propose I used to purchase this cow?
Here, tell them it's magic.
No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a cow for a bean?
Then steal it.
Steal it? Just the other day, you were accusing me of exercising deceit in securing the cow.
Then don't steal it, and resign yourself to a childless life.
I think it best if you go for the cow, for I have met a maiden in these woods these past few nights with a golden slipper, and I think I might be successful in securing one.
Fine.
Fine.
That is simply...
Fine!
Prince, before he could spirit her away.
I clearly say, children should listen.
No, please.
What were you not to do? Children must see and learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince, but I am old and I am ugly. I embarrass you.
No.
You are ashamed of me. No. You are ashamed. You don't understand.
It was lonely atop that tower.
I was not company enough.
No longer a child, I wish to see the world.
You know what's out there in the world. Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me. Princes wait there in the world, it's true. Princes, yes, but wolves and humans too. Protection, Rapunzel, and yet you disobey me.
Did you think I would stay in that tower forever?
You lied. Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor? Rapunzel, I will not share you, but I will show you a world you've never seen.
No!
When is a white cow not a white cow?
I don't know. Leave me alone.
Haven't I left you alone long enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In need of another cow?
What a beautiful cape you have there.
Stay away from my cape or I'll cut you into a thousand bits!
I don't want it! I was just admiring it!
My granny made it for me from a wolf that attacked us. She even let me help skin the animal and she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have. A golden egg.
A golden egg? I don't think you got that egg from a hen. Where did you get that egg?
I stole it from the kingdom of the giant up there. If you think this is something, You should see the golden harp that the giant has. It plays most beautiful tunes without you even having to touch it.
I'm sure it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom of the giant, get the harp, and bring it back to me?
I could.
Could not.
I could.
But not Mr. Liar.
I'm not a liar. I'll get that harp. You'll see.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise. And as he left from the tower, the thorns into which he fell into pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought. What would be his response? But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? But then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick when you're safe out of sight and yourself, but where everything's wrong? Or where everything's right and you know that you'll never belong? Whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting, and all once you're there, though it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, cause you're still standing stuck in this stuff on these steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Though at home they don't care, you'll be better off there, where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes, then from out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. I'll just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he, not you, who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew, on the steps of the palace.
Don't come any closer to me.
Please, just hear me out.
You've attacked me once before.
I did not attack you. I attacked your shoe. I need it. Oh, here. Here is a magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean. Nonsense.
Oh, don't do that.
I have already lost one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to lose another.
Please. I need that shoe to have a child.
That doesn't make any sense.
Does it make sense that you run from a prince?
Stop!
Oh, here, take my shoes. You'll run much faster.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yes!
Who was that woman?
I do not know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I've done nothing.
I have the cow!
Oh, you have the cow! I have the slipper! We've all four! Hey!
Yes. I will give this to the prince, and tomorrow we'll search the kingdom for the maiden who fits this shoe.
It's mine. I don't care if this costs me my life.
What was that noise?
Oh, sir, it's the boat of wagon far off town.
There you are. How dare you go off and search without me?
Well, my apologies, sir. I thought that I might.
Enough of what you thought. I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch. And there, when she ran off, remained the maiden's slipper.
That's brilliant.
I thought so, though it did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
Oh, and sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the slipper.
Ah.
Get them the slipper and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem
Shut up! Just give him the slipper. We only need one, and he's obviously a spirit of some sort.
Yes, if you insist.
There's a giant behind my shack! I came home and I heard Jack coming down the beanstalk, calling for his axe. And when he reached the bottom, he took it and began hacking down the stalk. Suddenly, with a crash, the beanstalk fell. But there was no Jack. For all I know, he's been crushed by that ogre.
Worrying will do you no good. If young Jack is safe, then he is safe. If he is dead, well then, there's nothing we can really do about that, now is there? Now, I must be off before my search is
done. Doesn't anyone care that a giant has fallen from the sky?
He is dead, is he not?
With such a thud, I would suppose.
A third midnight is here. You've all the objects.
Oh, yes, a slipper and hair.
A cow and cape.
That cow doesn't look like a cow to me.
Oh, but it is, but it is. It's a toy.
We thought you'd prefer a live one.
Well, of course I prefer a live cow. So bring forth this toy cow and I'll bring it to life.
You could do that?
No!
Son! Mother, look, the most beautiful heart.
You could have been killed coming down that plant.
What's happening?
Shut up! Feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me. Feed them to the cow. No! Go! Here, fill this.
I'll do it. Show me milk for me. Squeeze, pal.
Wrong ingredient. Forget about a child.
Oh, wait one moment, please. We followed your instructions exactly. One, this cow is as white as milk, correct?
Yes.
And two, the cape was certainly as red as blood.
Yes.
And three, the slipper.
And four, I compared that hair to this ear of corn.
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
You what?
I happen to be passing by.
Oh my gosh! I told you! I cannot touch any of the ingredients!
Oh no!
Corn!
What?
The silky hair of the corn, peel it from the ear and feed it to the cow quickly!
This had better work, old man, before the last stroke of midnight, or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son?
Please, not now!
Yet! Meet your father!
Father! Could that be you? I thought you died in a baking accident.
I didn't want to run away from you, son, but...
It's working! She's milking!
I don't understand.
Not now!
Come on,
into the cup.
Oh, we've done what you wish.
When can we expect a child?
What are you doing?
What's happening?
Where are you going?
Son! Son!
Father! Father!
He's repaired.
He's dead!
So the mysterious man died, having outdone the curse on his house, for the baker would have no reunion with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, who was punished with age and ugliness the night when her beans were stolen and the lightning flashed, was now returned to her former state of youth and beauty. Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was returned to the now wealthy Jack. And as for the prince, he began the search to find the foot to fit that golden slipper. And when he came to Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took the golden slipper into Florinda's room.
Careful, my toe!
Darling, I know!
What will it do?
You have to go! His magic can sit!
I'd never need to walk!
The girl obeyed, swallowing the pain, and joined the prince on the red carpet for all of the kingdom to see.
This one is not the bride, that's true. Search for the foot that fits.
The prince returned the false bride, asking for the other sister to try on the slipper. Swallowed her pain and joined the prince, not until he realized there was blood trickling from that shoe.
What's this? Have you no other daughters?
To which the woman replied,
no. Just a stunted kitchen witch his old wife left behind. She's much too dirty. She cannot show herself.
I insist.
And as Cinderella presented herself, she tried on that blood-soaked slipper, and it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I always wanted a son.
Shut up.
Much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, the prince took Cinderella and rode off.
Don't put it all within the shoe. This is the proper bride for you. Fit to attend a prince.
And finally, as for Rapunzel, she bore twins. I live impoverished in the desert until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he walked towards it. And as he approached, she fell into his arms, overjoyed at seeing him, and wept. Two of her tears wetted his eyes, and their stops restored his vision.
I was going to come fetch you as soon as you learned your lesson.
You're cute.
Oh.
Mother.
Yes. This is who I truly am. Come with me, child. We can be as happy as we once were. Come on, Rapunzel. You're the only family I know. Please! You and those beautiful twins of yours. You leave me no choice. What?
As is often the way in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her powers over others. And when the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Lucinda and Florinda attended, wishing to win favor with Cinderella and sharing a good fortune. But as the sisters stood next to the blessed couple, Pigeon swooped down upon them and poked her eyes out, punishing them with blindness. Now right. The kingdoms were filled with joy, and those who deserved to were certain to live a long and happy life. Ever after.
Ever after.
Journey over, all is mended, and it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and extended. Ever after.
Ever after.
All the curses have been ended, the reverse is wiped away. All is tenderness and laughter, for forever after.
Happy now and happiness and happy ever after.
There were dangers and confusions.
Oh, we did it.
In the past we would often swerve.
We did not.
There were constant
disillusions.
And they never lost their nerve.
Not a lot.
And they reached the right conclusions.
be clever when you see your wish pursue. It's a dangerous endeavor, but the only thing to do.
Though it's fearful, though it's deep, though it's rugged, though you may lose the path that you may kind of choose. You must stop your muscles, work your muscles, twist it. You have to relax, so follow your wish. You can tell your wish if you want to wish, but you can't just wish.
They were all content.
I never thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy. Not an unhappy moment since.
I'd be the sweetest prince. I never thought we'd have a baby.
I never thought I could be so happy. Such that you regret them, better that though than to never get them. I'm going to be a perfect wife.
I'm going to be a perfect son.
I'm going to be the perfect
mom. I'm going to be the perfect father.
I'm going to see that he is so happy. I never thought I'd love my life. I would have settled for another. Than to become a wife.
Than to settle for love.
Than to beget a child.
That fortune smiled.
We will expand our quarters in due time.
Why expand when we could simply move?
We will not move. This was my father's house, and it will be my son's.
You would raise your son alongside a witch?
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Oh, maybe he's cry. He's fine, and you mustn't hold him as if he were so fragile.
He wants his mother. Here.
I can't take care of him all the time.
I will take care of him when he's older. We had to go through thick and thin.
I hadn't been
so
happy.
Oh, my God. Oh my God! Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
And the baby.
He's fine too.
You! You're the one responsible for this, aren't you?
Always thinking of yourself? Look at my garden.
What of your garden?
Look!
Oh, what has happened?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
What could have done such a thing?
An earthquake.
No earthquake. My garden has been trampled. There are footprints.
Who could have done such a thing?
Anything that leaves a footprint that large is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
A bear. Bears are are sweet. Besides, you ever see a bear with 40-foot feet?
A dragon?
No scorch marks, usually they're linked.
A manticore.
Imaginary.
A griffin.
Extinct.
A giant.
Possible. Very, very possible.
A giant.
We should tell someone.
Who are you going to tell?
The royal family, of course.
Oh, my gosh. I wouldn't count on that family to sniff out a rat. With a giant, we'll have to go to battle. A giant is the worst. A giant has a brain. It's hard to outwit a giant. A giant is like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we are just an expendable bug beneath its foot. Boom. Crunch.
We are moving.
And so the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Look, Milky White, it's the butcher.
The baker.
The baker.
What can we do for you, sir?
I've come to investigate the destruction that was wrought upon my house today.
Jack has been home with me all day.
The baker went on to tell Jack and his mother that he feared there was a giant in the land.
I can go to your house. I can recognize the giant's footsteps.
You'll do no such
thing.
Any
help at all?
You'll get none from us. I don't remember you coming to my aid when there was a giant in my backyard.
A giant in one's backyard is one thing. A crushed home is quite another.
Look, young man, I wouldn't worry. Giants never strike the same house twice.
I will take this news to the royal guard nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Princess, I've come to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see one.
So how do you exactly know there's a giant in this land?
My house was destroyed. There are footprints.
That could have been caused by a number of things. Now, come along, Joshua.
Wait!
A house was visited not long ago by a giant which fell from a beanstalk.
I remember.
Princess, wait! I have a young child. He was very difficult to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I'll bring this up with the prince when he returns. Thank you.
Jack, I'm off to sell the harp.
Mother, no!
Jack, we don't want to harp around with a giant on the loose.
But I know how to kill a giant.
Enough! We've had our fill of giants.
Mother, if I could help.
No! Promise me you'll stay within your surroundings.
Mother, I'm a man now.
You're still a little boy in your mother's eyes. Now I want you to promise me. Promise!
Promise.
Good.
Your house.
We've had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
Well, there's no use frightening the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to do without the bread and sweets. Besides, I already have more than I can carry.
But why such a load?
I'm moving it with my Granny. We had an accident too. When I returned home, I found my house destroyed, almost as if a large wind had come in. My mother was nowhere to be found.
Oh no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off.
Good birds! What news of you?
What of Mother's grave? What kind of trouble? I can't go in and investigate. A princess cannot go into the woods unescorted. Good idea! I'll disguise myself and go see what's wrong. Thank you, birds!
We'll take you to your granny's.
No, you will stay here with the baby.
We're not gonna let her go alone.
I will go with her.
I don't need anyone to take me. I've been plenty of times
before. Not when there have been such winds blowing about.
That's right, we'll take you.
No!
I'm not about to stay here when a wind might return to this house as well.
I know my mother made me promise, but I'm gonna find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you think you're through at last, and then into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the weather's clear, we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here,
just to find the giant.
Into the woods, to grandmother's house.
path is straight, no reason then to hesitate.
Into the woods, it's not so late, it's just another journey.
Into the woods, but not too long, the skies are strange, the winds are strong. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
Into the woods to slay the giant.
Into the woods to heal the child's wings.
To find a future.
To heal,
to slay,
to find.
To fix, to hide,
to battle,
to see what the trouble is.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. You locked me in a tower all my life and blinded my prince and banished me to a desert where I had no food to eat and no company.
Oh my God! Because of the way you treated me, I'll never be happy! Rapunzel. Oh, I was just trying to be a good mother. Oh! No! Rapunzel, stay! There's a giant running about!
Good brother! What a surprise.
Brother, how good to see you!
What brings you into the wood today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
You? Investigating news of a giant? Father would never even do that. That's business for your steward. Less.
Well, what brings you to the wood?
It's my Rapunzel. She's run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman. She's been subject to hysterical fits of crying in moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell me what you're really doing here.
High in a tower like yours was, but higher, a beauteously. All around the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen, when the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas, just as unwakeable, what unmistakable agony is the way always barred. She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard. Agony, such that princes must weep. Always enthralled most to anything, almost, or something asleep.
If it were not for the thicket.
A thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
The quickest is pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves?
Dwarves?
Dwarves are very upsetting.
Not forgetting the tasks unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable.
Agony,
misery,
woe, not to know what you miss.
While they lie there for years,
and you cry on their biers, what unbearable bliss. Agony, that can cut like a knife.
Oh well,
back to my wife.
Oh my God!
Rapunzel, I must be off. Godspeed to your brother.
Godspeed.
Tepid travelers lost not only their way, but their patience as well.
Are you sure this is the right way?
We went down the dell.
Oh, perhaps you forgot the way.
The path is straight.
It was straight. Now there is no path.
Wait, where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Maybe we should just turn back.
No!
We'll just have to find Granny's without the path.
But my mother warned me to never stray from the path.
The path is straight from you.
Wait, that looks familiar. See? Three oak trees.
Yes, I see.
Oh, who might that be?
The bodyguard and the royal family. What brings you into the woods?
The castle has been set upon by a giant.
Oh, no.
I warned you. Why didn't you do anything?
I don't make the policy. I just carry it out.
And I warned you that you can't count on the royal family to solve all your problems.
I think it best if we go back to the village.
I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle.
Oh, no.
What?
All that's left of my garden is a sack of beans. And there's not much of your house either.
But I heard giants never strike the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
There!
Oh, the giant is a woman.
That size!
Where is the lad who killed my husband?
There is no lad here.
We haven't seen him.
I want the lad who climbed the beanstalk.
We'll get him right away. Don't move.
It was you who destroyed my house, not some great wind. You're the reason why I have no mother.
And who destroyed my house? That boy asked for shelter, and then he stole our gold, our hen, and our harp, and then killed my husband. I must avenge the wrongdoings.
But we are not responsible for him.
You're wasting your breath.
She's right. You can't reason with the dumb giant.
Not all giants are dumb. Give me the boy.
We told you he's not here.
I know he's there, and I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me!
The giant, who is nearsighted, believed she had found the lad. There is no consensus among them as to which course of action to take.
Oh, put a spell on her!
I no longer have my powers, and if I did, you really think I'd be standing here with all of you? Now, we'll have to give her someone.
Who?
The bodyguard. It's in his line of duty to sacrifice his life.
Don't be ridiculous. I will not risk my life for anyone.
Don't take it personally.
I'm waiting!
You must understand, these are not people familiar making such choices. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them to deal with a force this great. Sorry, I tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right!
Not one of
us. You're always on the outside.
And that's my role. You must understand, there must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
You're making a huge mistake.
Nonsense.
There must always be an objective observer to pass the story along.
Well, some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
If you drag me into this mess, you'll never know the story. I'll be lost.
Wait! He's the only one who knows the story.
Think of how fun it'll be when you have to tell yourselves. Think of your baby.
Oh, he's right. Leave him alone and put that away!
Now that's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos.
Yay.
There must always be an outsider.
Here's the lad!
I'm not the lad!
This is not the lad!
Don't drop! Why did you drop him into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of him too.
Well, we might have thought of something else.
If it were up to you, a decision would never have been made.
Now that he's gone, we'll never know what happens next.
But we'll manage.
Must I search among you for the lad?
No!
No! magic beans. If anyone is to be punished, it should be the man who made that exchange.
Oh, nonsense.
He was your responsibility. Now I must punish him for his wrong.
We've suffered too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You are getting me angry.
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing about our kingdom?
Shh, be quiet.
I'll hide my son where you'll never find him.
Don't upset the giant.
You'll never, never find him.
I'm warning you.
Don't go back to where you came from. This instant will get you for all you've done. Will?
Where's your son? Is that him?
This is not the bully.
No, the boy's hiding in the steeple tower.
If he is not, I will return and find you!
Rapunzel, get away from me!
No, stop, Rapunzel, no!
No, don't step on...
She's in poor condition. Wake up!
Don't let them get Jack!
We won't.
Promise me you won't let him be hurt as I stand here at death's door.
I'll do all I can.
Promise, promise.
I promise.
No, 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 come away from there. You! You killed her!
I was just doing it for the greater good. That's my job. I'm so sorry.
Children won't listen. No matter what you know, children refuse to love. Guide them along the way, and still they won't listen. Children can only grow from something you love to something you lose.
Life was so steady, and now this. When will things go back to normal?
Hidden kingdom.
Hello, peasants.
You can't take everyone.
Fools! There is nowhere to hide.
She's right. We have to stay here and fight this out together.
Others are cut off to battle giants, and others are not. I don't have it in my constitution. And as long as I can be of no help, I'm going to continue to hide. Everything will be just fine in the end.
Not always.
giant steps on the mall.
Oh, you don't mean that.
You were thinking the same thing.
This is terrible. We just watched 3 people die.
Oh, when did you become so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf is not the same.
Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop it.
I suggest we just find that boy and just give her what she wants.
But if we give her the boy, she'll kill him too.
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
Well, one step at a time. Well, maybe if he apologizes, makes amends.
Yes, he'll return the stolen goods.
Well, he's really a sweet boy at heart. She'll see that.
You people are so blind. It's because of that boy that there's a giant about in our land. While you continue talking about the problem, I'll find the lad, and I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
You're not gonna let her feed the boy to the giant, are you?
Of course not.
I'll just have to find him first.
Well, I'll come too.
No. Stay here with the baby.
We'll fan out. It'll increase our chances of finding him. Oh, but not you. You stay here with the baby.
You would leave her with our child?
The baby is asleep. He'll be safe with the girl.
What if the giant were to return?
The giant will not harm them.
How do you know?
I just know.
But what if?
But what if will only a giant's foot stop your arguing?
You will stay here with the baby. Please. 1, 2, 3.
Do you argue like that all the time?
No, not all the time.
It seems like you do.
Well, there's nothing wrong with having a little argument.
Oh, I see.
Melky! Melky!
Oh, Jack!
Melky!
Oh, Jack! Jack! Oh, you stay here with the baby.
But I want to come with you.
Oh, no, you'll be safer here.
Please don't go too far.
I will only go 100 paces. If I don't find the boy, I'll come right back.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Jack! Jack! One, 82, 83, 84, 85. Oh, hello, sir!
Hello.
Oh, you must be here to slay the giant.
Yes.
Have you come upon the giant yet?
No.
Well, I have.
You have?
Yes.
Oh, you again. What are you doing alone here in the woods?
Oh, well, my husband and... Well, it's a long story.
So, he would let you alone in the woods?
Well, it was my choice, really. I'm looking for the lad.
Your choice? How brave.
Brave?
Yes. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
Oh, this is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story. Oh, no, no, please, sir. We can't do this. You have a princess.
Well, yes, I do.
And I have a baker.
Of course, you're right. How foolish. Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please. Let your hesitations be hushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment after all. Seize the moment, skies may fall any moment.
Oh, but this is not right!
Right and wrong don't matter in the woods. Only feelings let us meet the moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment present as the present for the moment.
Excuse me, ma'am, are you all right?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
I'm so sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Oh, don't say that.
Well, it's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, you shouldn't be alone out here. There's a giant in the midst.
Well, I'm sure the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
You haven't heard? The prince is nowhere to be seen. No doubt off seducing some young maiden.
What?
I understand that's what princes do.
Not all princes.
You look just like the princess. Only dirtier. Oh, you are the princess!
Get up! I'm not a princess here.
What will you do?
I guess I'm to return to the castle.
You've not heard. The castle has been set upon by the giant.
And the prince?
Nowhere to be seen.
Oh.
Come with me. You'll be safe in our company.
The giant!
Oh, the giant! I had almost forgotten. Will we see each other again in the woods sometime?
Oh, you see, this was just our moment in the woods. Our moment, shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Any moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now I must go off to slay a giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I will never forget you, how brave you are to be alone in the woods, and how alive you've made me feel.
What was that? Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me? And kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up, stop dreaming, stop prancing about the woods. It's not beseeming, what is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband, no one lives in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for warmth, and a baker for bread, and a prince for whatever. Oh, never, it's these woods. Face the fact, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never end? That's what woods are for those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were only moments, even now and then. But if life were only moments, then you never know you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment who can live in the woods. And to get what you wish only just for a moment, these are dangerous woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an end when you're back to ore makes the ore mean more than it did before. Now I understand, and it's time to leave the woods. '81, '82, '83, '84. Oh. does not look like the right way. Oh, 81, 82. Oh, this is not right either. Oh, 90, 91. Jack, Jack!
She'd be back by now.
She said she'd only go 100 paces.
Well, I'm sure she'll return.
No, I'll go look for her. In which direction did she go?
Out!
Out! Look who I found!
Please don't let her give me to the giant!
Oh, it's not our fault that the giant wants you.
You're hurting me!
Let go of him! Leave him alone!
Where did you find this? Where is my wife?
She's dead.
What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her. She was under a tree.
He was crying over her like she was his own mother.
How awful.
How could this happen?
I buried her in a footprint.
I should have stayed with her. I shouldn't have left her behind.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now, it's time to get this boy to the giant before we're all so much as dead meat.
No!
This
Keep
is
away from
no
him.
Time to be soft-hearted. He's going to the giant and I'm taking him!
Yes, he's the one to blame. It's because of him there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
Yeah. But it isn't my fault. I was given those beans. She persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans, and without those beans, there would have been no stock to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, Magic. Beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told where they worthless beans, for they oversold, and the talents who persuaded you to steal that gold.
So it's your fault.
No.
So it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute. They only stole the gold to get my cow back. From you.
So it's your fault.
Yes.
No, it isn't. I kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get the cow to get the curse reversed.
It's your father's fault that the curse got placed and the place got cursed in the first place.
So it's his fault.
It was his fault. No.
Yes, it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute. Though I chopped down the beanstalk right, that's clear, but without any beanstalk, then what's clear is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Second place?
Yes. How?
Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean?
The other bean?
You pocketed the other bean.
I didn't, yes, I did.
So it's your.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So it's her.
No, it isn't. Wait a minute. She exchanged that bean to obtain your shoes, so the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife... Oh, dear, but I never knew it, so I threw... Well, don't look here.
So it's your fault.
But
see, it's her fault. And it isn't mine at all.
But if you hadn't gone back up again...
Marie.
You were greedy. Did you need that hand?
But I got it from my mother.
So it's her fault, then. Yes, and what about the harp in the third place?
The harp, yes.
She wouldn't dare me to.
I dared you to.
You dared me to. She said that I was scared to. She dared me.
No,
I
didn't.
So it's your fault.
Wait a minute.
You hadn't dared.
Left the harp alone.
It wouldn't be in trouble in the first place. Well, she raised the beans in the first place.
I didn't raise them in the first place.
She raised the beans in the first place.
It's your fault.
You're responsible. You're the one to blame. It's your fault.
Gold, broke a little vow. Did you have to get your prince? Have to get your cow? Have to get your wish? Doesn't matter how. Anyway, it doesn't matter now. It's the last midnight. It's the boom splat. Nothing but a vast midnight. Everybody's. We can always give her the
love. No!
No, of course, the crazy mattress is the blame. Someone you can blame. Fine, if that's the thing you enjoy, placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Just give me the boy.
No!
No.
You're so nice. You're not good, you're not nice. You're just right. I'm the good, I'm not nice. I'm just right. I'm the another bean. Beans were made for making you rich. Cut them as they say. Here you want some more. Listen to the roar. Giants by the score. Well, you can play it on the witch. It's the last midnight. It's the last bus. Now before it's past midnight, I'm leaving you by the the garden, it's yours, separate and alone. Everybody down on all fours. All right, Mother Wren, lost the beans again. Punish me the way you did that. Give me claws and a hunch, just away from this dungeon of gloom. And the doom, and the boom. Cry!
Maybe I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path. Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes. Maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had our way out of this together.
It doesn't matter whether we're together or apart.
But we need you.
You don't understand. My wife was the one who did everything.
You would leave your child.
My son will be happier in the arms of a princess.
All right. All right, come on. Come on. Jack! Jack!
Dead.
Not completely. Are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
I strayed into the mother, the garden, to get your mother a gift. I foolishly took some of those beans for myself. How was I to know? How were we ever to know? When your mother died, I ran away from my guilt. Now, aren't you doing the same?
No.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions, please. No more tests. Comes the day you say what for. Please, no more.
We disappoint, we disappear, we died, but we don't.
What?
Disappoint in turn, I fear, forgive though they won't.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo, left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. Feelings. Time to shut the door. Just no more.
Running away. Let's do it. Free from the ties that bind. No more despair or burdens to bear out there in the yonder. Running away, go to it. Where did you have in mind? Have to take care unless there's a where. You'll only be wandering blind. Just more questions. Different kind. Where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, get to it. Why sit around resigned? Trouble is sun, the farther you run, the more you feel undefined. For what you have left undone, and more, what you've left behind. We disappoint, we leave a mess, we died but we don't.
We disappoint in turn, I guess, forget though they won't. Giants waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives till that happier day arrives? How do you ignore all of the witches, all the curses, all the wolves, all the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses, all the wondering what even worse is still in store, all the giants, children. No more.
I knew you wouldn't give up.
He wouldn't leave his baby.
Seemed like he was going to.
Give me my son. He always cries when I...
What are we to do now?
We'll have to come up with a plan.
What?
We have to think of something quick.
If only there was just some way that we could surprise her.
She's too tall to surprise. Good bird! I need your help now more than ever. What of the prince? Well, that doesn't matter now. What matters is that we find a way to kill the giant. Can you help? You could do that? Thank you, birds! You can talk to birds? The birds will help.
How?
Well, when she returns, they'll swoop down and peck out her eyes until she's blind.
What good will that do?
Well, then you can surprise her, or strike her, whatever you do to kill a giant.
But she'll just get angry.
She'll thrash about wildly.
And she'll crush us all. Smear the ground with pitch. Lure her to an area smeared with pitch, and her shoes will stick. She won't be able to move.
And then I will strike her from behind.
Strike her? From where?
Yes, from where?
An old tower.
What tower?
Between those two trees, an old tower.
Yes, send her to the tower.
All right. We have to think of something, and we gotta move, quick, before it's dark.
Here.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm excited!
Come on.
Oh, no, no, no. Don't cry, little one. I know, I know. You want your mother.
Hello.
The giant went in that direction.
Is that... My darling, what are you doing here in those old clothes and with a child? Never mind all that. You must go back to the castle at once. There's a giant on the loose.
The giant has been to the castle.
No. No, no, no. Are you all right? My love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love, am I?
Listen, I love you. I do, but yes, it is true.
If you love me, then why would you have strayed?
I thought that if you were mine, that I would never want for more. And part of me is as happy and content as I've ever been, but I don't know, there still remains part of me that just needs more.
I have on occasion wanted more, but that does not mean I went in search of it. This is how you behave as a prince, then what kind of king will you be?
My darling, I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I didn't ask to be king, and I'm not human. I'm not perfect, I mean. I'm only human. Please forgive me.
I think you should go.
Leave, but I do love you.
Consider me to be lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream. Now, I want something real. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince. They're almost finished! You see there, between those two towers, when the giant returns, that is where we are to center.
Good!
Ugh, I wanted to climb the tower too.
Well, I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone.
I'm so sorry.
I think my mom and my granny would be upset with me.
Why?
Because they said to always make them proud. And here I am about to kill someone.
Not someone. A giant that's done a lot of harm.
Yes, but she's still a person. So shouldn't she be given forgiveness? My mother would be very upset with the circumstances.
Mother cannot guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you.
My mother hears I've slayed the giant.
Jack. Your mother is dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
She was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you. She was struck a deadly blow by the prince's bodyguard.
Why would she do that?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No one.
The bodyguard will pay for this. After I slay the giant, I will slay him.
He will do no such thing.
But he shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
Yes.
Then he should be punished.
He will be, somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions. I don't know.
I'm going to kill him.
Fine. Kill him. No. Don't kill him.
Mother isn't here now.
Things, right things.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's true?
Nothing's quite so clear now.
Things, fight things.
Feel you've
decide, but you are not alone.
Believe me, no one is alone.
No one is alone, believe me.
Truly, you move just a finger.
Say the slightest word. Something's bound to
the boy.
He's not here. Yes, he is. We can't go on hiding him any longer. He must pay for his wrongs.
Quick, tell me where he is.
He's over there. You see in that tower where the birds are gathered? Jack is hiding there.
Thank you. Now justice shall be served and I will leave your kingdom.
No more killing.
Where am I to go now that I have no one to take care of me?
You'll have to take care of yourself, Jack. It's time.
No, it's not. I'll take care of him.
You will?
Yes. I'll be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend. And a pet.
Of course. Since we have nowhere to go, we'll move in with you.
No.
It'll be fun.
My house is in shambles, and I would hardly... Of course, you can move in with me.
Pinny shall join us.
You'll not return to the castle.
Well, I'd gladly help you with your house. There are times I actually enjoy cleaning. How proud your wife would have been of you.
And how sad it is that my son will never know her. Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
But how will I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Yes, calm the child.
Tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother. You'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wood. Do not let it grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone. No one is alone. Hold him to the light now.
Time in a far-off kingdom lived a young maiden, a sad young lad, and a childless baker with his wife.
Careful the things you say, children will listen. Careful the things you do, children will see. Children will listen. Children will look to you for which way to turn, to learn what to be. Careful before you say, listen to me. Children will listen.
Glimmer.
I think I see a glimmer.
Thank you.